ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
ॐ वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकीपरमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुम्। ॐ एडोरेशन्स् टु लार्ड् कृष्णा, दि प्रिसेप्टर् आफ् दि यूनिवर्स्, डिस्ट्रोयर् आफ् दि फोर्सेस् आफ् डार्क्नेस् एण्ड् बिस्ट्रोयर् आफ् इमोर्टालिटि।
श्रीमद् भगवद्गीता चैप्टर 17 एंटाइटल्ड श्रद्धा त्रय विभाग योग द योग ऑफ थ्री फोल्ड फेथ। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर लेट मी रीइटरेट, लॉर्ड कृष्णा सेड टू अर्जुना, यह शास्त्र विधि उत्सृज्य वर्तते कामकारतः न सिद्धिम वाप्नोति न सुखम न पराम गतिम। ही हु इग्नोर्स द स्क्रिप्चर्स एंड कंडक्ट्स हिमसेल्फ अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज ओन विम्स डज नॉट अटेन परफेक्शन और हैप्पीनेस और द सुप्रीम गोल। दिस लेड टू अ लिटिल कंफ्यूजन इन अर्जुनाज माइंड because there are many people who don't turn to scriptures. They just live their life guided by their faith. What will happen? Will they all go to hell? So that's how the beginning of the Shraddhatraya Vibhaga Yoga, the yoga of threefold faith. Arjuna uvacha, ye shastravitim utsrijya yajante shaddhayanvita tesham nishtha tuka krishna sattvam aho rajah tamah. Arjuna asked, those who renounce the ordinances of the scriptures and worship God on the basis of their faith alone, what is their position, O Krishna? Is it sattvic, rajasic, or tamasic? In other words, those people who are led by faith and they have not gone into the study of scriptures, they are not guided by Guru, and there are many who even surpass people who go to satsanga, etc. First point, faith. Also understand the importance of the word faith. Faith and religion are synonymous, at least in modern times. That's why we call interfaith. Faith is the very soul of the religion. Faith moves mountains, though that's not the purpose of life. The Sanskrit word for faith is Shraddha, which is a blend of two words, Shat plus Dha. Dha relates to buddhi, intellect. Shat, truth. Absolute truth. Pure intellect holds the truth like a pot with water holds the sun. To understand, the intellect doesn't wait for intellectualization. It doesn't wait for arguments, rationalities, calculations. give you another simple illustration. Newborn babies, whether in human realm or in animal, bird, they look at the mother. Sometimes they don't even look at them. But there is a tremendous affection. For that affection, between the two, the baby and the mother, there is no rational explanation. And that affection does not wait for somebody to give a little lesson in biology. That baby is yours, it's your responsibility. Not joking. Just like it is so normal, natural. Similarly, faith in the individual is like a mother source. No one exists without faith. Now, the quality, the faith can be good, perfect, implying the excellent, mediocre, dull wit. Always faith or anything you study comes under the three gunas. Sattvic faith is real faith. Rajasic faith is a shaky faith. Tamasic is a distorted faith. Why the changes? Because souls have come through many lives, and they have been led by their karmas. So therefore, all do not have the same quality of faith. Just like all don't have the same type of health. Put it in a more crude way. Think of appetite for food. It's a healthy expression. But your appetite can be healthy, normal. It can be erroneous. You're hungry, but we're eating things that are going to put you into trouble. Or you may suffer from chor bhook. Stealthy hunger. Hindi word chor. Hunger has gone into you like a thief. It doesn't belong to you. Faith has a similar role. If you are really healthy, faith will be most dynamic. Just let me reiterate from the Raja Yoga. Shraddha, virya. Shraddha leads you to spiritual strength, spiritual valor. Life is always filled with valor. When you become angry, you throw all the glasses. It's an expression of valor. You bring out words that you have never read in the literature. You become eloquent at this stage. Let me summarize it. So, Shraddha, if Shraddha is your healthy Shraddha, then it will lead you to real spiritual valor. You will do, think rightly. You will bring integral yoga in daily life in a very healthy manner. Now, if that is so, Shraddha, Virya, smriti, what you understand about yourself is always distorted, is based on ignorance. Early in the morning you think you are the wonderful person. By the evening you think you are helpless and miserable. When you are dejected, you turn your memory to all those things that have been painful in the past. So memory in human being operates in a, again according to those three gunas, Sattvic, Rajasic, Tamasic. Sattvic memory, you begin to move away from the normal way of thinking, I am this personality, I have that much money, I live in a particular place. Instead, I'm a ray of God. God realization is my goal. And the type of memory, when it is fully blossomed, it puts your ego away. Not the ego, I am that. The same I am to which enfolded you when you were in deep sleep. Your normal I am, you kicked it. So memory allows you to have that understanding that all the troubles, anxieties, sorrows, miseries, negative thoughts, fear and all that is based on your ego. But that ego does not stay in your deep sleep. You kick it. So it is not your reality. If you evolve in a spiritual way, you can hold the ego, at the same time not fall for the tricks of the ego or for the illusions of the ego. Ego is like a monkey, you see. You can have a monkey pet. You can keep the monkey always on your neck. But let not the monkey tighten its feet around your neck. So, what I'm leading you on, when you have that type of recall, mystic recall, I am not the body, that leads you into samadhi, not in normal set of your mind. Normal set of your mind, there is always data from the past, present, your expectations for the future. But when you are in samadhi, you have thrown this all away. Just like if you are swimming, you have before you all those waves and whirlpools and many things. You are seeing ducks and ducklings. Okay. Dive, all that goes away. Samadhi, you are diving. So faith leads you to that level. So what happens? Now your intellect no longer stays as a rational intellect. It becomes intuitive intellect. Intuitive intellect perceives things spontaneously. Again, I bring you the simple illustration. Some blind men were given the task of studying an elephant. There are people who are blind and they are handled by good men in many wonderful ways. And so in order that they don't face a life of boredom, the teachers, those who are tending upon the blind men, they give the blind men many type of tasks to keep them busy. I'm spicing the story. So they were given the task of studying an elephant. One blind man touches the elephant on the trunk. He says, the elephant is like a snake or like a rope. Another touches the body. It's like a wall. Another touches the foot, like a pillar. Another touches the ear. Oh, it's the winnowing fan. And now can go on imagining many more. And the leader among that group, the monitor of that group, he comes to present the thesis, that's the research. The elephant is a blend of soup, rope, winnowing fan, pillar, and tail is like a broom. This plus this plus this plus this equal to elephant. But there happens to be a man with eyes. He opens the eyes. Oh, is that an elephant? Nubs. Not the sloop plus wall plus the pillar, it's the elephant. Now think of it, how it applies in your practical life. When you think of yourself, the world, even God has created. He created the earth. When did he create? Created all those stars, suns and all that. The omnipotence of God is a blend of the creator of the Himalayas, the creator of the ocean, the creator of the stars, the creator of the sun, the creator of the moon, and there are 1,000 names. But intuitive intellect, the intellect becomes intuitional. None of this. Nada exists. Nothing exists. Brahman alone exists. So understand the intuitive vision that transcends your intellectual function. Shraddha ultimately leads you to that level called prajna. Now, in the second verse, Lord Krishna replies, Trividha bhavati shraddha dehinam sa svabhavaja sattviki rajasi chaiva tamasi cheti tam shrinu. The Blessed Lord said, faith inherent in one's nature is of three types. Three types in the embodied beings: sattvic, pure; rajasic, impure; tamasic, dull. When you hear about it, let me also explain to you. You may be born sattvic, rajasic, tamasic. You are born sattvic, there's no problem. But you are born with a rajasic faith. The fact is that from many lives you have followed the path of karma, path of desiring for fruits, and you have not dissolved anger, greed, hate, the malas, gross impurities. So, from the very beginning, faith does not show in its healthy state. But if you begin to enjoy satsanga, do spiritual sadhana, be guided by spiritual personalities, you may change your faith. From Rajasic, your faith can become Sattvic. Also, now from Rajasic to Sattvic, it's easier. But if you are born with Tamasic faith is very distorted, ugly. Terror, people of do terrorizing activities, they come with Tamasic faith. But if scriptures do not hold any restricted view about them, the best of our scriptures have come from that type of personality. Valmiki was a terrible monster, he was a robber who indulged in violence and wanted to rob Narada of his veena. And Narada sent him, rather asks him, "You are doing all this negative karma. Do you know the fruit of karma? You will have to experience the result of all this karma." He said, "Not only me, all my family, because I'm doing this for my family." He says, Will your family join with your hellish experience? Go and ask." So the story says he goes and asks his wife, his children. Say, no, we don't know what you are doing. It's your duty to help us, sustain us. We are not supported by you for going to hell. Anyway, I don't want to bring this story too much. Valmiki develops tremendous dispassion, comes to Narada, "Please initiate me." Narada asks him to repeat the divine name, Ram, Ram. And Valmiki's conscience was so bitter. He said, "Such a divine name, my tongue cannot repeat." Then Narada asked a dead body nearby, "What is that?" He said, "Mara." "Mara is dead." Narada said, "Repeat, Mara, 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 Mara." Ulta naam jagat jab jana, Valmiki bhai brahma samana. That Valmiki, starting in that manner, became highly enlightened, not ordinary enlightened. He's the greatest poet. He wrote all the Yoga Vashishthas, Valmiki Ramayana. All that came from a person who started with Tamasic faith. So, while the study is being made, no one is being discouraged that now you are gone forever because your faith is Tamasic. Now, in order to evolve, you must know the characteristics of these three types of faith and try to align your life along sattva. Sattvanurupa sarvasya shraddha bhavati bharata shraddhamayo yam purusho yo yat shraddha sa eva saha. Faith in every individual is according to the nature of his chitta. Chitta is the mind. More properly, chitta is the buddhi, intellect. A person is of the nature of his faith. Whatever his faith, so he is, O Arjuna. Now this is brought into in in Upanishadic statement, a clearer picture is given. In Taittiriya Upanishad, Atma Vijnanamaya, the Upanishad describes the intellect-ego blend called Vijnanamaya Kosha. And it is described in an allegorical manner. It is a bird. Every sheath has been described as a bird. Now this Vijnanamaya, Tasya Shraddhaiva Shira, your Vijnanamaya, intellect, ego, layer, the head is faith. Shraddha is the head. Ritam Dakshinaha Paksha, Satyam Uttaram Paksha. Rita, truth has two names, synonyms. Rita and Satya. Rita term comes, truth as it is. Satya, truth as you have conceived. Conceptual truth and essential truth. Those are the two wings of the bird of Vijnanamaya. And the head is faith. In other words, your whole movement is guided by your head. So in your spiritual path, as is your Shraddha, so will be your guidance. Shraddha is the guiding head, as is your faith. And faith is not something simple that I will change my faith. In the relative world, one can change. The Hindu can become Christian, Christian can become Hindu. That's a different type of change. But real faith, the faith that you are born with, that faith cannot be changed. It can be changed by following the spiritual process. Now, let me finish that allegorical description of the bird. Tasya Shraddhaiva Shira. Faith is the head of Vijnanamaya Kosha, of intellect ego blend layer. Ritam Dakshinaha Paksha. Truth, real truth, is the right wing. Conceptual truth, Satyam Uttara Paksha. Conceptual truth is the left wing. Yoga Atma and the very core of Vijnanamaya relates to the Divine Self. Maha Puchha Pratishtha. And the tail of the bird, which means support of the bird, is Mahat, cosmic mind. Well, that's a very highly allegorical description of faith. Yajante Sattvika Devan Yan Yaksharakshansi Rajasa Pretan Bhut Ganansh Chan Chanye Yajante Tamasa Jana. The Sattvikas worship gods. If you are sattvic, you will enrich your life by Daivi Sampat, divine qualities of humility, generosity, absence of vanity, devotion to God, and so forth. And in that process, a sattvic mind moves towards God. But in the early stage, God is not realized as one and absolute. The mind has different angles. If I want wealth, I must turn to Lakshmi Devi. If you want wisdom, I will turn to Saraswati Devi and tell Lakshmi Devi, please. Don't listen to what I'm saying. Human mind is quite foxy. Creation. Turn to different gods for different requirements, different needs. But if you advance in your faith, then it's one God who appears in different ways. You may continue to be worshipping Lakshmi, Saraswati, Durga, Hanuman, Ganesha, Krishna, Rama. You can continue to worship different deities, but with full understanding that one God is known by different names. Then your Shraddha has become much, much more powerful. Uttam, best type of faith. Uttam, Madhyam, Adham. The best faith, Uttam. Rajasic faith, Madhyam, mediocre. Tamasic faith, Adham. Adham, lowest. Lowest with hate. As I have, let me explain this point. I have not completed the fourth one. Rajasikas, so Sattvikas worship gods. Rajasikas worship Yakshas and Rakshasas. So it is not to be taken literally. A Rajasika may be worshipping the same gods. You may have the same Shiva mantra, Rama mantra. But though you are worshipping, what you want from God? More money. And you have invested your money, you want the investment. Double up. Money needs two types of attention. Maintaining it as it is. You don't go into loss. That's called Rakshasa. Rakshasa word comes from, this is the ancient economy. Varuna is the god of treasure. Varun god. He has two attendants, Yaksha and Rakshasa. The Rakshasa term comes from Raksha. Protects your investment. Keeps it as is. But this whole set doesn't lead you to liberation. Therefore, what is a good name, Raksha, has become Rakshasa, a demoniac. It conveys a demoniac meaning. And Yakshas also. Yaksha is one who is like fox. Looks at your principal investment and start putting how to invest it in so many things. And shows you a paper. Look, your money has multiplied. And all that money doesn't come to you. In a very allegorical way, what is being told to you that Rajasic faith does not accomplish anything profound. It goes into the world of Maya. Another way, the Hindu scriptures have done. When you speak of 108, your mala has 108 beads. One represents progress, 1, 2, 3, 4. 8 represents Maya. 8 by 3, 24. 24 is much bigger than 8. But add 2 and 4, it is only 6. And you don't understand that. Multiply by 5, it is 40. Much greater, but it's only 4. That's the predicament when your progress is based on money. And you are a worshipper of yakshas and rakshasas. And tamasikas worship bhut pret, lower spirits and ghosts. The Sanskrit word is bhut pret. Bhut relates to past. The tamasika continues to hold things that happened in the past. The tamasika holds a grudge. 16-year-old grudge or whatever they call it, 7-year-old. And the tamasika does not have any rationality. He doesn't ever think, why am I putting my mind crowded with this nonsense? There are good things to hold in my mind. No. Those wicked people. Now their 6th generation is here. I will not allow them to live. Until I do that, I can't be in peace. This is the example of being dominated by bhut, past. And pret, souls that come into new embodiments. In other words, there were enemies. But those enemies are not with you. They have gone away. But your anger towards your enemy looks at people. Whosoever has a nose similar to your enemies. Will break the nose. It's completely irrational. Nothing to be surprised. That is how the mind works. And then again, come back into people in the world who literally have the concepts of ghosts and spirits, and they become deeply involved in how to please them and use them as their instrument. And with this, I'm going to conclude. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purname Vavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om.